All right, the job of returning some newly discovered art masterpieces to their owners is a pretty daunting one. In a nondescript apartment in Munich, Germany, experts found more than $1 billion worth of artworks, many of them apparently stolen from Jewish families during the Holocaust. Their heirs now want a complete list of those works by Picasso, Matisse, Chagall, and others, hoping it'll help them recover family treasures that were taken from them so long ago. So that discovery created a whole lot of excitement in the art world and raises an important question. How many more stolen artworks still haven't been found? Christopher Marinello is an art expert who specializes in recovering lost works. He represents one of the families trying to recover their properties. Joining us right now from New York. Good to see you.
Nice to see you. Thanks for being here.
Well, this sounds like a Herculean task to try to find the families to match them up with these masterpieces. How do you do that?
Well, it's extremely difficult, but the magazine in Germany that released these photos, the family immediately recognized this particular Matisse as one that had been looted from them.
Mm. So you're hoping that a lot of families are very familiar with the art, the trove of art that, you know, their ancestors had. That seems rare.
Well, what's happened here is that the German government has not released a list or enough documentation for claimants to come forward. And that's one of the things we're imploring that they do. They're giving an excuse that there's a criminal investigation going on right now or that they don't want to be inundated with claims. But I must say that this is a time to be inundated with claims. The horrors of the Nazi Holocaust are still with us 70 years later.
So tell us about the family that you're representing and the art that they believe is theirs and they want to claim it.
Paul Rosenberg was the premier dealer of his day in Paris pre-war, and then managed to get out of Paris with his life. After the war, he came back looking for hundreds of paintings that had been stolen from him, and his family has not stopped that search. They're continuing generation after generation.
Was there some sort of documentation that Mr. Rosenberg left so that the family members would know what was taken, what was missing?
I actually have it with me right now. We filed the claim electronically this morning, and I'm about to send by overnight mail the balance of the documentation. The archives are intact for Paul Rosenberg. We can prove that this piece was looted by the Nazis. We can prove that Paul Rosenberg acquired it from the artist Matisse
himself.
Is
that a Matisse? Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. You said acquired it from Matisse himself.
Paul Rosenberg was Matisse's dealer, so he acquired this piece from Matisse himself. The provenance we have is incredible.
Wow. And so now, what about the family? What do they want? If it is retrieved, if they get to acquire this piece, do they have any plans of what they would do with it?
Well, you see, this is not about the money. This is about the lives that were upended by the Nazis, about the horrors inflicted on these people. And recapturing a painting like this is recapturing some of their pasts. It's reconnecting with their past and reconnecting with a life that was taken away from them.
Mm. Wow, it's very powerful and extraordinary to learn that we're talking millions of dollars worth of incredible art. Pieces that do art historians believe they, you know, that didn't exist, or had they ever wondered about, you know, some of these masterpieces that have since been recovered?
Well, for example, this Matisse had been investigated by the monuments men at the time, so we know these pieces existed, but but we don't know where they've been for the last 70 years.
Christopher Marinello, thank you so much for your time. Incredible story, incredible search.